Hi, and welcome to our weekly market update from Morton Brown Family Wealth. I'm Dennis Morton here with Katie Brown. How are you, Katie?
Great. How are you?
Good, good. Merry Christmas. It's December 21st. We're heading into the crux of the holidays, and just wanted to send along some best wishes for the season to all of you, and also share with you some things that we've observed this year through a lens of our three words. Every year we choose three words that try and help define and keep us really on point throughout the course of the year. And this year, Katie, you want to share the three words that we had for 2020?
We set these in December of each year. So we actually just kind of went through the exercise to set our words for 2021. But for 2020, our three words were focus, collaborate, and compete.
Right. So we're going to take a minute today to talk about, you know, as we reflect back on the year that was, this crazy pandemic year, how those words helped us, and also some observations about what we learned through the lens of focus, collaborate, and compete. So how did we focus better in 2020?
So focus, and you know, it's so fascinating because you start out with one thought of how you think it's going to apply to the year. And then as the year unfolded, we realized it was a slightly different meaning and a very good word for this year. We were just given this hand of cards this year where we didn't know what was to unfold. And I think focus was a great word because we started to recognize things that we can influence and things that we can't influence. Mm-hmm. And to really kind of focus in on the areas where we can make a difference, where we can create opportunities and try new things. And I think that has been a really helpful guide. And we did. We reflected on that often. We said, all right, where can we focus our energy now? Because it can't be in ABC areas. So how do we create those new focal points?
And even these weekly videos were something where we said, this is something we can do to stay connected and keep in touch. So it's something we tried. Focus was also being aware of our surroundings, noticing more of the things that we can do and having that hyper-awareness. I know we saw that professionally. We saw that personally. I mean, you talk about people saying like, how can I make my at-home work environment better? What are the things I can do with my kids? What are the ways I can engage with my family? That awareness of surroundings, if we carry that into 2021, you know, and as we kind of emerge from the pandemic, that's probably a healthy thing, right?
Yeah. I love that thought of being intentional about the things that we can change and can impact and not just relying on, it's just going to happen in the course of,
no. Right.
Regular daily activities, because right. A lot of things that would just normally happen before didn't happen this year. So to be intentional about what we could do.
Very true. So collaborate. This was going to be the year of engagement and collaboration. We were going to do a lot of events this year. That was going to be our focus, right? So tell God your plans, right? What ways did you think collaboration still worked this year?
You know, there's collaboration with other professionals. And once again, being very intentional about reaching out and keeping those relationships going and figuring out, okay, this is new. This is a new environment. Maybe we're using new tools, new platforms. How do we share that with other people? How do we learn from one another? Mm-hmm. So there were a number of different places that both of us reached out kind of proactively and said, hey, how are you doing what you're doing now? Right. How are you utilizing your technology? And so forth. And so I think there was a lot of collaboration with other professionals, other firms, both inside of our industry and outside of our industry. And the collaboration amongst our team, just really, really strong collaboration there. And I think that has brought out kind of a new, different level of confidence in that we really had to trust in one another's abilities. We had to trust that each of us were going to stay focused on the areas that we need to be focused on and that we could bring it together to work together.
Right. All those, that confidence and trust building, all those skills that you have to create the conditions to have that work. And suddenly the conditions were there. You had to do it. So, and I think that was really, really awesome. And there's a level of understanding too. I think when you're collaborating with people this year, it's an understanding of, hey, we're all meeting at a place that's a lot different. So let's step back, not make a lot of assumptions and meet people where they are. I think that's another really healthy thing. Going forward into 2021, meet people where they are, figure out ways to work together from that point and not make assumptions and go from there.
Right. Yeah. And have some patience too.
I think
all of that kind of went into the collaboration, that understanding and that ability to get to know people on a more personal level in some different ways and recognize how we can support one another at different times.
Yeah. So our last word was probably the trickiest word for us. We struggled with this one heading into the year, compete. We had a lot of conversations pre-2020 about, does the word compete fit? Is it about winning and losing? And I think when we settled on the word compete as our third word for 2020, it was about showing up as our best selves. It was waking up every day, challenging ourselves to be the best advisors we can be, the best business leaders we can be, parents, spouses, all those things. There's a level of showing up and doing the good work. And I think this year it was necessary. There was the opportunity to backslide a little bit if you didn't challenge yourself to show up and compete every day to still bring your best. I was really proud of how our team did that this year. And I think compete ended up being a pretty important word for 2020.
I would agree. I think more than ever, we all kind of have an attitude of, all right, we can do this. Whatever's thrown at us, we can figure it out. We can be nimble. We can be flexible. We're going to bring our best selves, our best ideas to the table and be willing to compete in that sort of preparatory way, like always preparing, always being ready. Obviously, that's something that we continue to work at. It's not easy every single day, but I think it is very much in kind of the culture of our firm to lift one another and make sure to have that optimism together that we can do this.
Right. We're going to sound like a broken record on this, but we are so anti-prediction when it comes to thinking about what the future holds. You know, you're not going to hear us say this is going to happen or that's going to happen. And this was the ultimate case of, who knew 12 months ago that this is how the year was going to shape up? So there is no magic to the work that we do as advisors. There's no magic to life or parenting or spousing or anything else. We're going to work through this together. That's the idea. We can show up. We can work through things. We can work through challenges and opportunities. And that's a great lesson to carry into 2021 as well. I think our three words were really helpful. Anxious to share our three words for 2021 here in the new year and help you think of three things that might be good concepts for you and your family as you prepare for life in the latter stages of pandemic and as we move into life beyond. So we wish you and your families all the best this holiday season. We know many of you may not be able to see loved ones, but we do hope you maintain the ability to connect. And thank you for all of your support and all the things that you allow us to do in the course of the year. Katie, any closing thoughts for 2020?
Just thank you. You know, just a really, really good year for, once again, gratitude. Appreciate all of your patience, all of your, you know, connections and inquiries throughout the year and just the ability to work with you and your families. So thank you so much. We hope that you have a happy and healthy holiday season and end to the year here.
All the best, and we'll see you in 2021. Take care.